how or why did the thrust and the negative thrust go towards anti-BJP as well? What was BJP's issue with the Aam Aadmi Party, the IAC at that time, that brought the BJP into the crosshairs as well and suddenly became worse than the Congress? While the Congress was undergoing all the scams, the thrust was there towards the BJP. The second one I want to ask you is that while Arvind, I think, is definitely integrity cannot be questioned, the people he's gathered around him, I wonder whether that integrity level still applies. I don't know, but Somnath Bharti has made an ass of himself. Yeah. This Tomar guy has made a stupid fool of himself. Rakhi Birla has made enough. Everyone you see around him, other than the two he's got rid, the two bright guys he's got rid of, they seem to be all the wrong kind of people. So where will we end up?
I mean, I'm not.
Sir, how can she answer that
question? I think
it's the political party that can answer.
No, but I can say there are still
yes, some ma'am, your question.
There are still some, but yes, Prashant and Yogendra will always
but be wrong. This point is taken, sir. Point
your point is taken. But I just reply to the point that he was making about Congress and BJP. Should I reply?
That's the one I want to
really should I really reply? Please, sir. I mean, yeah, Congress and BJP. 1 minute, ma'am. I'll just reply to this then. Because it's an interesting question. So the Congress was in power, right? And the BJP is very, the RSS and Baba Ramdev, everybody is part of the Anna movement in a very large way. I mean, please get a book, you'll see all the evidence, please get it. So they're very much there. But the change happens after the movement is wound up and the Congress is already defeated. You know, then it's, you know, the same thing happened, like you create a Bindranwale and then it comes and bites you. So, I'm not saying it's exactly like that, I'm not saying the BJP created it, but once you have a force, and there is definitely a shift, once he decides to create a political party, then his partners and companions change. It becomes Prashant and Yogendra. It becomes a very left-oriented thinking. It becomes, and here I will also make this point that in politics in general, the principle of politics, of those who succeed is, you must go for the, you must first get a chunk of the poorer sections of society. Then you can get small other plus. We are talking of a first past the post system. So they were not wrong in their political orientation and thinking. Besides, Arvind did come from an activist background, which wanted to do something. I mean, let's have no debate on that. He was not born into anything. Here was a guy who did want to clean up the system one day, come into politics the next day. He had the desire to do something. Of that we can be in no doubt. You know, so the target changes, the whole situation changes once a party is formed. You know, I think that's the explanation. You know, yeah.
Yes, ma'am. So next question, sir. Sir, 1 minute.
Well, I'll be just precise, and as General Ban said, be sharp also.
Yeah.
So I want a feedback. You have answered most of the questions, but I want a feedback. Let me tell you, I'm not busy, but okay. So mine is, what do you think as a journalist for Kejriwal, where he says aap plus me is equal to Mac after Yogesh Yadav and Prashant Bhushan's excellence.
Aap plus me is equal to?
Aap party plus me, that's Kejriwal, is equal to Mac.
To me.
Me.
Everything is he himself.
He didn't say that.
He said, he does that. After Prashant Bhushan. After Prashant Bhushan.
No, no, ma'am, I heard his speech to the national executive. I heard it. He didn't say all that.
He didn't say that, but we concluded.
He probably meant that.
The way he knew Prashant Bhushan and Yogesh Yadav is close to subordinates and colleagues.
Ma'am, I'm not doing that. You know, everybody keeps getting to that. Really, the whole issue of what happened there, what was going on over there, is all in the book. So please do get it, you know. So,
yes, Kavi Khanna sir.
Governance has been a casualty in my opinion from the time we became independent. There is something wrong with our constitution and our systems which produces people, which allows people like Lalu Prasad and Mayawati and now Kejriwal to subvert the constitution and the systems and get to the top and go on experimenting with the nation. And the nation suffers and the people suffers. With your deep understanding of politics, can you tell us what changes, if at all, will you suggest so that this kind of thing does not happen and the nation doesn't go and generations are going?
I think, sir, that is beyond the scope of Sabha. We need a change in the constitution.
No, the only way you can do that is to suspend election.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Come on.
Hello.
He's a poet. Let's hear what he has to say.
Hello.
Yeah. I can hear you, but you can use the mic also.
Can I ask a question?
Yes, ma'am. Just let him after that.
Good evening. The chair suggested that we ask questions that are short and sharp. So my question has two parts. One is very short, and the other is
sharp.
the short part of the question is that you mentioned you spent a long time working the BJP beat as a political journalist, correct?
Right.
Great.
That's my main, I cover everything. I cover Congress, BJP, but my, now I'm not a political editor, I comment on everything, but my basic years have been spent covering the BJP. Yes, okay. You're right.
Yeah. I'm the short part. I'm interested to know, do you bring to your point of view in the political commentary a personal dislike of the BJP?
That's not a fair
yes
question.
Or no?
Question?
Yes or no?
No, that's not a fair question. Next point.
Yeah. The other part is that if
it is not a fair question.
No, that my point is
no, I'm sorry.
Would you tell us three things about the BJP that you do like?
But we are not talking about the
thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. There's a question here.
Yeah,
yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. You are on.
Thank you. I think we have to be very objective, and I think we are all intelligent people, and no personal comments on anybody are not welcome. I would like to congratulate Sabha on bringing the book out so fast. Thank you very much. And regarding the confrontation with the LG, why is there no thought of a referendum? Why haven't they thought of a referendum on the Delhi state or removing the LG? Why not?
Oh no, Anjali, you can't have a referendum in India. You can't, you have a plebiscite issue hanging in Kashmir. I know. Look, you have Scotland and you have Greece. These are small countries. In the spirit of democracy, we should have referendums on everything. But it is not mandated by the constitution, number one. And we have an issue hanging. Once you start taking these kind of things, so it's a... I don't think even Kejriwal intends to have a referendum. It's a pressure tactic to talk about this full statehood to get his way. He has to keep up the pressure because he has a hard time with the LG. At the center, there's no love lost. The system as such, he has a hard time with that. So referendum is not only, I think in the conventional way of thinking, you can't start having referendums. You need to, it's too big, too complex, too diverse. That would be the response.
Last three questions.
Yeah. Besides what we've read in the newspapers and seen on television, could you give us an insight into what really happened, when that farmer died at the Aam Aadmi Party rally?
Yeah. I don't think they had a clue that there was a death initially. And then I think that they were very, very crass in the responses that came out. I was not there. It was very near Parliament. It happened in Jantar Mantar. But I think the guy was a... I don't want to say this if this will come out anywhere, but the fact is that what we all think, a lot of us, including BJP and Congress and everybody thinks, this particular farmer, he was into this kind of political stuff. He was doing a stunt and it went wrong. It's who wants to say this about someone who died? I wouldn't like this, He was doing a stunt and it went wrong. That's actually what happened. He'd been trying to get into this party and that party, So this is what even the BJP guy, because I go to all these debates, so you'd be surprised to know how the format is, because so many of them are such good friends. So after we have argued, we all sit and we chat. Or in the studio waiting room, So they were also telling me that it was that. But, one can't say it because a human being died and, we saw the unfortunate sequence of events. Yeah.
Last two questions. Yes, sir, you wanted to ask.
May I bring the focus back to what is supposed to be?
Could you hold the mic closer, please?
Yeah. Can you hear me better now?
Yeah.
will it be possible to bring the focus back to what is supposed to be the subject of the talk, which is the impact of art on the citizens of Delhi? I don't think that has been really addressed clearly. What is going to be the impact? It could take a very long answer, of course, but there should be, if I may say so, would it be possible to get some concrete views on what is likely to be the impact on citizens, and what criteria will you use to judge that?
Short and sharp.
I mean, impact can be in so many spheres, you know, like I did say that there are two, okay, let me say there are three, four things which have happened which are unusual. Number one, now what will be the impact of this? It will be difficult. They are going to increase the circle rates of property prices in Delhi, which means that you will have to register things that this is going to happen soon. Number two, they had a budget just some days ago where they followed, they have demolished the idea of the MLA quota. They had something called participatory budget, which was tried out in a place called Porto Alegre in Brazil, which means they took 11 constituencies and they did these general sabhas over there with all sections of society, and they want the people in those constituencies to determine what they need there. So he is going on that. The problem with AAP has become, it's really interesting because AAP has got a lot of, I get called from people in like I was saying in Oxford University, and somebody asked me in Paris, there's a lot of people are writing papers because it is experimental politics. It is new people breaking into the political system. There are all these things about it, right? Into a system which is fairly corrupt. It is people without big financial backing getting in. So there are these three, four things that have happened. Now, but the irony is that possibly most people are not even aware of it, because the news structure is such that you only get to report the scandals. So these are the things that are happening. Now, what the impact will be or not be, I mean, did any of you know that the MLA fund has gone, that you now have a different kind of a budget? I think they have made the highest allocations for health and education in their budget. You know, they've made a very large allocation for publicity, which is very, very interesting to me when I came back, because they did the whole campaign literally on a laptop and mobile phone. Arvind would record a voice, it would be played on FM radios, but now they've gone in for big publicity, and I think but it's also because the heads, various, they've clubbed it all together. Part of the reason is they do believe that we need it, because the conventional media is not going to be with us otherwise, you know, that, so they have very quite deliberately gone in for publicity. And why grudge them? I mean, we know how much the Bharatiya Janata Party spent on the campaign, and everybody does it. I mean, and you know, one of the most important things that happened after I came back, I think the Supreme Court asked why political party funding cannot be covered by the right to information. Because really, that is at the rot of it, you know? I mean, if you're going to have, and the sort of the money, according to the Election Commission, the accounts that the BJP submitted, they spent 700 crores on the national campaign. That is the accounted money. I mean, also, in a country like this, if you're spending these on campaigns, huh? You know, so these are questions that we as citizens have to ask.
Yes, the last question.
Yeah, sure. Sabha, after the government has come in, there has been a lot of drama that's been happening here. And the general sense is that there is a, you know, the governance has been casualty. What's your view on that? Has the governance really been a casualty in last 4-5 months?
I think that it's created, Aam Aadmi Party has very, very high media scrutiny. And you can't, I mean, on one, it's a double-edged sword. At one time, from nothing, there were other people's movements not covered. From nothing, this Arvind Kejriwal and all became household names. But this is the price also of media scrutiny, that everything that you do gets reported, everybody's looking, you know. And but I actually feel, like I'm saying, there are a few things which we don't even know about. Because I have taken the trouble to find out, because I wrote a book, because the publishers came to me, and I cover everything in politics, and to me, fundamentally also, I'll say as a citizen of India, it is very fascinating for me to see new people actually break through. I mean, come on, it's a system. You either have to be a son or a daughter or belong to a party which has crores and crores, you know, these were ordinary people who broke through the system. So that is exciting to me as a citizen, and I don't want that experiment to fail. And I think we must give, I don't believe that there's been a misgovernance, as said. I think we just have to give them some time for all these things to kick in. Now in my area where I live, there has been no power cuts. I don't know what's happening with you guys. The power last year, I remember, for 3-4 days, the power shut down in Delhi. I don't know how many of you remember that. So these are simple, simple things, you know. And I know this about the power sector, because at one point when they came in, the power companies, you know, they have a standoff with the power company. They really pile on to them. They're really giving them a hard time. But ultimately, the power companies also have to do business. They can't do the city like Delhi. And I know, you know, so it's like, you do what is required, otherwise you go, kind of a thing, you know. We'll find an alternative way to do it. So there are, I don't know how it's been for you guys, but for me, in where I live, there were lots of power cuts. It hasn't happened this summer, you know. I was away, but I was told by those in Mahul, hamare ilake mein bijli nahi gayi. So, achhi baat hai ji. You know, that's it, this is a small thing. Thanks.
Can you give a mic, please?
In how many years Kejriwal will occupy the 7 years post?
No, I don't.
In how many years Kejriwal?
Sorry, what's the question? What's the question?
He asked me how many years Kejriwal will occupy 7 years post. 7 years post. I mean, he's saying when will Kejriwal become prime minister? Now, you know, I have just said that he has been very clear. You know what he said? क्या मैं नेपोलियन हूँ जो जीता रहूँगा? He said that. So I think he's very focused on Delhi right now, and I think they're going to give Punjab a try. They will send their cadre and all to Punjab. That's it.
When he comes to 7 Race Course Road, we'll invite him to Gymkhana Club also. Right. It remains for me to thank Sabha for a really wonderful talk, and the kind of interaction that has taken place shows how much interest she aroused here. As far as the bijli is concerned, I must say that even in my area, the bijli has stabilized. But unfortunately, the unauthorized and illegal construction has gone up 10 times. So there's a plus and a minus. Now, as far as somebody asked, you know, what happened after the elections and how will things go? So I'm quoting only from Sabha's page 9 of her book, in which she says, post the Delhi elections, when the Congress was wiped out and BJP got 3 seats and all, she says, Rahul went on a sabbatical, Modi sold his suit, and a lot of people lost their shirts in the Aam Aadmi Party. So on your behalf, can I request you all to give a resounding thanks to Sabha. And we change the format a little. And on behalf of the club, the Memento, I'll request one of the ladies to come forward and give it to her. Any lady volunteer to come forward? Aap aaiye ma'am.
So you can take a photograph.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for all your cooperation. Thank you very much.